السلام عليكم. This is engineer Ziad البصير. A new training and comparing Primavera P6 EPPM 18.8 web-based with the professional capabilities. Now, this is the professional version, the application, and here is the EPPM web-based. And of course, if we look at the first difference between the Primavera P6 Professional and the EPPM, that in the EPPM, there is a dashboards. These dashboards give us very good insights and information, customized as we want, of course, on the information we need about our projects and our portfolios. Unlimited possibilities, unlimited options, to a certain extent, to be honest with you, but still giving us what we want. If you have really big database and big projects and you are a very huge organization, then you need to work in different databases. That's normal. It's becoming very huge to manage in one place. So for organizations with 100,000 activities, this software is very good. And you can manage it very well in one database. More than that, you need to go for another database. However, coming back to the differences. So the dashboard available in the EPPM, it's not available in the professional application. It's number one. Number two, now this tab for portfolios, it gives us good information about portfolios in one place. And here in the EPPM and the Pro, we need to customize our views, bare portfolio, to see what is there, but still not that good according to this information here by these graphs. There in the EPPM and the Pro, we will see them as tables, Gantt charts sometimes, but it will not give us the information we want. Here, of course, we have to open all. I open all projects, for example, here. And I can see the information here for all activities in one place. Now, this is the database, the simple database from Oracle. So it's not really a real one. I have another big ones, but again, I can't just open some other client's information. There is some confidentiality around it. But the difference what we are talking about is, now portfolios management here, it give you whatever information you want. For example, this view here, it give us financial rating for all these projects, okay? And based on, are we doing the right projects criteria, okay? I can go, for example, and say, let me get something budget by location. And here it give me a different view with the cost and percentage of the budget for this portfolio, which is the IT portfolio. And let us look at different information we can get from this portfolios. Of course, all these views, it might be applicable to some portfolios and not to others, but let's check. Let's see the traffic lighting, for example. Now, traffic lighting is very good to give us indication about each project, what's going on it. So in this portfolio, the IT portfolio, we have this project which has overall status of the project is good. Schedule status, costs, quality, and scope and risk. So this project looks good. The second project, it's okay until it comes to the risk assessment and it seems it has some high risk. And we should go and check, for example, this project, why is the risk is there? And we need to analyze it further to check and highlight this such project. The other one has overall status, a yellow alert, which means something is really happening. It seems here relating to the cost. And everything is good. So it seems it's running overrun cost or something. The other one is 78 score. Overall status is good, but quality and scope has issues. And we go to the other one, and we see here overall status alert, and the alert is related to, now this one is not clear, but it's even with all this greens ones here, this one is having 62 scores and have alert, and we should go to the project itself to understand what is the situation. The other one has a risk assessment issue. The other one has a high risk, and this one is a small risk. And as you see here, really this information is very good. And you can understand from each portfolio, from each program, from each project, what's going on in a dashboard or score cards, I mean, for all of this. So there is limited, unlimited opportunities on using EPPM. So what professional can give us similar to this data is nothing. I mean, what you see here is just the Gantt charts, the activities. If you go to the EPS, you go here and you start looking at start date, finish date, progress, and that's it. You can't get more than that in the professional application in managing these projects. Yes, you can see a lot of information if you go and use the table view, a lot of information, but not in the charts. You can't make compare, for example, between both portfolios. You have a limited capacity in working here. All numbers, and numbers, you know, it's a lot of numbers. If you have 100 projects here, or 200s, or 300s, or 400s, it doesn't matter how small they are or big they are, it's a big numbers to monitor every time in a meeting. So EPPM become a must for all companies who they are running projects. Now, you have a database which is closed and secured, give you charts easily to manage your projects. You can do this, by the way, in Excel, definitely with some programming and this and that. However, Excel is a very easy tool to change. You can play the numbers, you can do a lot. But here, as soon as you add information, it becomes very difficult to change. The baseline is a baseline. If you want to change something, you need to change the baseline before. So the change will be monitored also. And if you have a very good security administration here in the EPPM, nothing will go inside unless approved. So here we notice a lot of capacity to work within EPPM dashboards and portfolios. And there is other things you can do by this system. It is all about data. If you build your data correctly, you can get out of it a lot of information, a lot of information. So the first step for any organization is to have their data built correctly. They have to have all projects' data, from cost to budget to resources to performance to quality to documents, everything. It has to be in the database. And after that, you can filter, represent, demonstrate every single information in different method. You want it to be by charts. You have plenty of charts here to choose from in different forms. Bubble chart, histograms, lay charts, scorecards, side-by-side histogram, stacked histogram, and more. And you can also compare. Here you have a compare. And you can compare between, you know, different areas of the portfolios and projects. Very simple. I will not go in all details now with this. I mean, there is a lot of things you can do in capacity planning and performance status, in projects administration and management, in resourcing capacity. and approvals of timesheets and approvals of everything, and linking all this to team members so they can update and review and give you insight of what's going on the site. And because this system is a web-based system, it can interact easily with any others web-based which can communicate with Primavera P6 EPPM. Everything become more easy to program, to bridge. So for any organization, if you don't have yet EPPM on board, you should have it. Because when you will start trying to do dashboards or to do portfolios management, and you need to start having all of this in one place and easy access by anyone, by the way. If you know, when you go for Excel, you know, even if it is in the server and you can access it from different places, you are accessing it, it blocks other users from using it. If there is anyone updating it, it's the same. And if there is any Excel sheet or file communicating to the other files, it becomes a headache when somebody open and change while the other ones are reviewing. In Primavera, different users will have the same view, live, fresh. One single click from your side. The CEO can open and check his dashboards as designed as he wants. The project manager, the director, everyone can review his project in the same time while everyone are working. This is Ziad Albasir, recommending highly to use such big software and important software for project management and portfolios management and high level project management. Thank you very much for watching. Please, if you have any questions, write it down in the comments. We are surviving because you. Please subscribe, like, comment. It helps us a lot. And share, of course, our videos, please, if you like it. Thank you very much and most welcome.